This is something that some of you really need to hear. It's not you. Let me repeat it. It's not you. People in general have this tendency that when someone leaves them or when someone is fed up with them, that it's something they've done. Well, why is it that when someone's upset with you or done with you, that it has to be you? Now, in some cases, it may be something you've done that they've decided they have enough about. But it's still them that chose to have enough. Unless you were a narcissistic vampire that drained them unto death and they left, then it was you. But if you were not a narcissistic vampire that was drained them unto death, then why does it automatically come down to you if they decide to leave or if they decide they have enough of you? Why is it you? Listen, you are not that powerful that everything bad that people do is because of you. Look, I don't care if you have defects or dysfunctions. There are people out there who just don't want to face anything in life. So if you have defects or dysfunctions, the least they can do is point out that there are solutions. That's one way they can help you for free. Some people don't even want to do that. It can be that you are a bit shy due to some traumatic incident happened in your past, and you're doing whatever you can to heal. But from time to time, you don't really respond like they want to. And now they're fed up with you. They don't want to hang out with you anymore. What's going on? They are impatient because they are all about them. They are full of themselves. They only consider themselves. And because you don't give in to what they consider is love, or is rightfully theirs, that means your attention, they leave. So what did you do wrong? Absolutely nothing. Because it's not you. Why is it that we are conditioned to always blame ourselves when someone else does something to us that's bad? Society conditions you that way so that you won't hold society accountable. That's what it's about. Look, if there was an argument or if there was a fight and you had your part that was wrong, admit that. But if the other individual had his or her part that they don't want to admit and they leave, then that's them. If both admit that they were wrong and both want to work towards a solution, that's good. If only you are expected to admit you were wrong and they just blame it all on you, then that's wrong. Even if they only have 1% part of it, they should still admit their 1% and work on their 1%. If people always say it's you, they are lying. Yes, they are lying. They just don't want any responsibility nor accountability. Too often, when people decide to leave us, or they have enough of us, or they betray us, we go on the inside looking for where the defect is. And if we don't find any defect, we will seek confirmation from others to find out what's wrong. But what if there was nothing wrong with you? Or if there was something wrong with you, who told you that is that's the wrong with you that caused them to leave? What if they are wrong or they are exploitative and they found someone else to exploit and that's why you don't exist anymore? We should not attach meaning to what people do to us without doing proper investigation. Oh, let me repeat that. We should not attach meaning to what people do to us without proper investigation. Too often, we attach a negative meaning when someone does something negative to us, something hurtful to us. Hold on. Who did it? They did. If you triggered them, then you triggered them. But still, something's triggered in them, so still they need to find out what's in them that was triggered. If you were wrong, you were wrong. But just because you were wrong doesn't give them the right to treat you as if you're non-existent. And if you were terribly wrong, then you need to accept that it's right for them to leave. If you were terribly wrong. But if you were not terribly wrong, it was just a common defect or a common dysfunction on your part, then why are they treating you like you're the worst criminal, the vilest demon around? If it's about wrongdoing or if it's about being defective, why are they not so blatant and obsessive in their anger against those that rule society? Those that rape children and do satanic rituals. Why not? Because it's not about right or wrong, good or bad. It's about them not wanting to face any discomfort and they just drop you because you don't give in to this demand. It's them! When it's not you, it's not you! I don't care if people call you a narcissist. If something is not you, then it's not you. If it's scientifically testable that it's not you, then it's not you. So stop thinking it's you while it's impossible that it's you. That's also a trap Satan has put many in, causing them to think it's them while it's not them at all. Of course you should self-reflect. Of course you should improve. Of course you should apologize if you were wrong and contribute to solutions. But examine yourself long enough to be sure that you indeed had a part in the wrong or not. Don't allow people to blackmail you into thinking you're wrong if there was no wrong there to begin with. That's a type of blackmail. Again, just because you're open and transparent about what you want doesn't mean you're right. Okay, so of course you should reflect on yourself. But still, also reflect on the people who are upset with you. Reflect on them. Just because you're upset does not mean that you owe them to be frightened and you owe to be kind of, let me say, just because you're upset doesn't mean you're supposed to take over their anxiety. That's what they want. They're upset and they want to transfer it onto you, whether through violence or through other means, so they are at ease. You're not obliged to take that over. You are obliged to contribute to solutions and to operate in basic decency towards other human beings. That's what you're obliged to do. But they should do the same to you also. Stop thinking it's you when it's proven it can't be you. Be at peace.